Hi, this is Greg with Best Choice Trailers. So I'm going to take you for a walk around an 8x16, 14,000 pound short track Gooseneck Deckover dump trailer. This particular unit's got the fold down side option. It's got the hinges going down the side there. So let's take a closer look around this unit. We'll show you all the standard features. So everything you see here comes as equipped. There is no options other, of course, than the gooseneck. We're going to start out up front. It's got dual set bolts. It's got the spring latched neck. Of course, your safety chains, your breakaway. It's got the reflector tape in the neck. SureTrac does a gusset plate on the neck. A lot of manufacturers don't do that, but worth noting. They also do the gusseted neck. So instead of just putting a piece of channel in the back of the neck like we sometimes see, they not only put the channel in the neck, but they also put the gusset going from the horizontal to the vertical. Dual 12K jacks. If you're not familiar with the 12K jacks, they are spring loaded, so it'll spring up when you pull the handle. It's got dual grease zerps. SureTrac changed to a I-beam neck and a front full width toolbox. This is something we've been asking for a while. Finally got it, so it's got the nice I-beam neck. It's got the 110 volt charger built in, so you can simply plug that into house current, keep your battery maintained. Now, one thing on this particular unit, SureTrac's jumped up to a Group 31 Deep Cycle Marine battery. So this is a good bit bigger battery than what you'd normally find in a Group 24. The most important number right here is going to be the 205 amp hour. A traditional Group 24 battery is going to be a 140. So you're going to get about a time and a half the battery life out of this particular unit. You also note that it's a scissor hoist because this has the bigger reservoir. So on the scissor, it's a power up gravity down, and with that you get the bigger reservoir here. Speaking of gravity down, you get a little bit more dump cycles per battery charge out of this particular unit. Does have a 20-foot all-weather remote cord, power up, gravity down. It's got grease zerts on the toolbox hinging, and then the 110-volt charger. Just bought in the neck for a spare tire. It's a mount there that you can put a spare. So this particular unit's got a 6-inch heavy wall mainframe, and then it's got a 5-inch tube under frame bridge. You got a very strong frame here. Again, those are heavy wall tube instead of the traditional 1/8 or 3/16 inch that jumps up to a 1/4 inch wall. Of course, you've got your 16-inch 10-ply radial tires, easy lube hubs. These have the new forward adjusting brakes. SureTrac also does the slipper spring suspension, and you'll notice it's got what they call a wet bolt kit, or basically a grease zert on the slipper there for added serviceability. Now, they do stop the 5-inch underframe bridge back at the spring hanger, and then they go to a 3-inch underframe the rest of the way back. So again, you've essentially got a double frame on this particular unit. Now, you do have an integrated chain hold down on this because it is not hydraulically locked in place. So you could hook that up for peace of mind when loading equipment. Got an underbody tub here, big enough to fit a spare tire in. Ideal spot if you do get the spare. Of course, on the gooseneck, you've got the spot in the neck as well. Generally, this box here is big enough for picks and shovels and straps. And if you want to put some hydraulic fluid or extra, again, big spot there for work-related or straps or whatnot. Now, on this particular unit, they've gone to an oversized hoist. Instead of a traditional 5-inch hoist on this, they've gone to a 6-inch. You also notice this is a Champion hoist. One thing with Champion, it is made in the USA. On this, they also use 100,000 pound tensile strength steel. So this is not standard steel. This is high tensile strength steel. They've put grease zerts on this particular hoist. Got a number of different ones, and then again, this is a 6-inch hoist. So again, normally on a 7K axle trailer, you're going to see a 5-inch hoist. Undermount ramps on this are standard. Now, one thing SureTrac does on their deckovers, because the trailer does sit just a tad higher than a load profile, they extend the ramp. So instead of a 6.5-foot, 80-inch set of ramps, they extend these out to 90 inches. So again, the load angle on these is going to stay about the same as it would with a load profile. It's important because most manufacturers in the industry put the same ramps on the 7 as the 8 wide, so you end up with a little bit steeper angle. Now they do also put half inch plate at the end of the ramp instead of quarter. We see some in the industry that put quarter inch and this area wears out. On theirs they do half, okay? They also put a retainer that would keep the ramp from pulling away from the trailer. New for 2018, Short Tracks widened the ramps just a hair and also put slightly heavier runners on the unit. This is a trailer where Short Track goes with a little heavier bed frame. This is a 5-inch tube heavy wall instead of the traditional 4-inch found on most of the low profile units. This unit does have 5 hinges going down the sides. They are equipped with greasers. These here would be your rope rings that would give you tie downs. If you put a tarp kit on it, you can secure it. The carabiner here going part way down the side would be if you were using the doors as a barn door mechanism, which is customary, so you'd swing it around, hook the chain onto the clip. Very simple design, very effective. This unit's also equipped with a spreader, so you can hinge it from the top, set the gauge at the bottom, pull the pin. One nice feature I like about Short Track is generally their gapping. Now this one's on a little bit of an angle here, so it looks off. Their gapping's generally straight the way they do these. They do spot weld it and square everything up before they finalize it, and we get a nice true sidewall panel that folds down nice and easy. Now these pin systems also are pretty slick, a little nicer than most. Don't work as well when they're up in the air, but these just rotate 90 degrees and then pull out. Very nice design. Rear door, hinges simply swing open. They've got zerts on each one of those. Now this is an 8 wide deck over. It's 96 inches outside to outside. It's about 102 inches, which is your max legal width. Short Track's using 10 gauge steel on the floor. Of our different manufacturers, these guys store all their steel inside. Now they're one of the few that do that in the industry. So they store their steel inside, they blast their finished product with steel grit, not sand grit. And then they do a zinc primer type process before they powder coat the unit. Of the different manufacturers we carry, these guys certainly have one of the cleanest finishes that that we have to offer. A couple other details on the scissor, they double header. Use 4-inch tube on the header for the scissor. Also coming on back, they're using 4-inch to box in the scissor. Now another detail on these are a 4-inch cross member. A lot in the industry are going to be a 3. So if you check these, I think the spacings are going to be about as tight as most. They're also going to be a 4-inch cross member on the bed of the unit. A couple other things on these, they use a tube frame. They cap the end of the tube back here with tube as well to keep you from ever crushing it. Put a little bit heavier hinging on. They also put the zert on as well. Short Track also takes the time to silicone between their different units to keep rust out of any cracks or crevices in the trailer. This is offered in an 8,000 pound axle. We do generally tend to keep it in stock with the 8s and the 7s. It's also available in a 14 foot length, which we also generally carry. And then if you need something bigger, they also offer in a low profile, a triple axle, and then a dual tandem and a deck over. So this would be the 8x16 deck over dump. Short Track calls this a 14,000 pound GVW. They do not count tongue weight into the equation. A trailer like this is going to weigh in the mid to upper fours empty. We'll say 5,000 pound for an even number. 14 minus 5 is 9,000. You're also going to pick up about 22% or 3,000 pound of pin weight. So max on this, assuming all things were perfect hypothetically, 22% pin weight, perfect weight on each axle, you could theoretically get upward of about 12,000 pound on a unit like this. Another little detail I did fail to mention, but I'll point out, Short Track does a 20-inch fold down side. Most of the ones we see in the industry are going to be an 18. It is only 2 extra inches, but it does seem taller when you look at them. So again, that's a 20-inch side. Also worth noting that keyway in the side gives a lot of additional strength to this sidewall. I've seen some that do a vertical upright, and it seems relatively speaking flimsy compared to the integrated keyway. So again, that integrated keyway gives a lot of strength whenever you fold the side down. Now the side is light enough, one guy, you pick it up in the middle, can generally handle without too much problem. And there again, you can see they're gapping top to bottom on these, generally pretty spot on. Again, this is equipped with a scissor hoist. Generally on the low profiles, they offer a dual ram at a little bit cheaper price point. On these Deckovers, they go straight to the scissor hoist. Currently, these are not offered with a telescopic hoist. Might be coming down the road, but again, right now, not currently offered. If you have any questions on this or any of our other trailers, feel free to check us out on the web at bestchoicetrailers.com. Or you can give us a ring anytime at 717-220-4220. Thanks for looking.